today is someone who's been accused of murder, has a near-death experience, an affair with a teacher at her school, fall into the clutches of an evil religious cult, and more happily is now busy preparing for her wedding next week. Her character's quite a handful too. Please welcome Home and Away's bad girl, Selena Cook, the gorgeous Tempany Deckert. Here, even though you're away from your native country.
Oh, I know. I feel like I'm speaking an Australian accent now, but
You've got a thick Australian accent.
No, I don't at all. And I don't know, the show seems to make people believe that I do.
No, I don't think it does. What do you think of our pastiche of your culture? Was it desperately offensive, as I suspect it was?
I'd
just like to apologise if you're Australian. I'd just like to apologise. Now, Tempany, what have you brought in for us today?
Okay, these are called lamingtons. And my friend wanted me to do a joke about lemmings and have them dropping off the table, but we're not going to do that because it's not funny.
If you had two of them together, would they be a lamington spa?
No.
you can thank Mel. It was Mel's gag.
Okay.
Mel's other half. Then.
But yeah, they're really nice. They're really tasty, and I can't believe you guys don't have them. But I actually think it's a bit of a conspiracy in Australia because sort of your grandmother makes them for you, and I think it's the fact that when you get old and you're not looking so great, I think they sort of like try and feed them to all their young kids and stuff to make them look fat and ugly and, you know.
Oh, right. So it's an old person's revenge on the younger generation,
it's a conspiracy.
What is this? A sponge, then? Is this a sponge square?
Yeah. And what you do is you cut them in half and you put, like, jam and cream in them to make that extra bit more cholesterol.
Mm-hmm.
But what you do is... This is the first time anyone's let me in a kitchen.
we never could have...
Because I'm actually really bad cook, but, like, you do...
Can I just ask what your name? It's a very interesting name, Tempany.
Yes, it's actually English.
Is
it? It's my grandmother's surname. Now I'm going to get really messy here.
It sounds a bit like tympanum or timpani, the drum.
Yes.
So I won't make any banging gags.
Well, that's the awful thing.
Rain off the banging
gags. I actually looked it up a little while ago and sort of, you know, did a bit of research into my name, and it said derived from timpani, the drum.
Oh, it did actually say that?
Yes. So thanks, Mum and Dad. I'm named after a drum.
The meaning of names is irrelevant. My name means lily. As in, sort of, lovely, pretty, sort of, snowy thing on a mountainside.
Oh, but that's nice.
Yeah, but it's incorrect, isn't it? You know.
No, you can't put too much on because you've got to taste the chocolate, right? So that's what they look like.
So that is desiccated coconut and, is that butter cream icing?
Oh, yeah, it's like a really fatty, chocolatey, creamy sauce, but you can actually thin it down a little bit so it makes the cake a bit moister.
Mm. Now, Selena's getting married. Your character Selena's getting married next week. What's going to happen? Can you give some inside gossip? Is it going to go well?
It's a soap wedding.
Oh, good.
It doesn't go to plan, there's quite a few mishaps on the way.
Really?
And I can't really tell you anymore, but let's just say that I didn't have to stay in the dress for very long.
Okay, well, check that out.
Which was a good thing.
Selena's wedding. Thank you so much, Tempany, for coming on. We're going to go out into the lounge and eat this in a little wee while. Now, Mel, in my imagination, there is no hesitation. We walk together hand in hand.
Perks! That's so sweet. Of course, in my imagination... Oh, they're perky.
Hello!
Come in with the lamington there.
These are lamingtons.
You see, this makes me very happy because I know about lamingtons.
Do you love lamingtons?
Yes.
Let's pass the lamingtons round.
Do you know Tempany?
We just met.
Yeah, just met.
So nice to have you on.
The two Aussies.
Okay.
Let's test the lamingtons.
Have a quick.
Chocolate's trying to eat them and get them everywhere.
Yes.
Okay.
Right, it's about that time again, and as Sid Waddell might say, the forum is like a wasp in a jam jar with a lid on. So, who's on line one?
Hi, it's Katie.
Hi, Katie.
Hello, Katie. How are you doing?
I'm fine.
Oh, who's your question for, my love?
It's for Kylie.
Go for it.
If you had a chance, would you ever go back to Neighbours?
No.
Very good reaction. So that's a no, then.
No, sorry, it's just that there was a report recently in the newspapers that I was going back to Neighbours, which I heard...
Probably.
I need to have a word with you.
Yeah.
No. I mean, I just think it was special at the time, and I wouldn't kind of fit in again. And I'm biased because I think it was better in old days anyway.
It was nice and
naive.
Yeah.
So no.
No, she's not coming back.
But I do believe Charlene calls occasionally. Apparently she has a baby or something.
Yes, she does. Yes, she does.
I didn't even know.
Well,
I'm the last person to know these things.
They didn't even tell her she had a child, Katie, for goodness sake.
Thanks for calling, Katie.
Okay.
Bye.
Bye.
Oh.
they go straight to line two. Hello there, line two.
Hello.
Hello. Who's that calling?
Hiya, girls.
Hiya there. What's your name, my love?
Craig.
Craig.
Yeah, it's for Mel and Sue. Which famous people would you last like to go on a date with?
Ooh. It's for Tempany and Kylie,
I think. Tempany and Kylie, my love.
Oh,
we're guests today.
Kylie,
we present
Mel
the show.
Mel and Sue.
Present
these are our guests.
Love. I'm very important, interesting people. Craig, my love.
Tempany and Kylie, who would you most like to go on dates with?
Famous, I mean, he said
famous people. Calm.
Willem Dafoe.
Willem.
He is, isn't he?
He
isn't he a one?
I don't think so, lad.
Oh, no.
I tell you that he likes sharks. The teeth go back into the head.
Oh, Dolly, you've had it to Peter Purvis.
What I know, Dolly.
Your judgment criteria is down the pan.
How about you, Tempany?
Oh, I don't know. I hate these sort of questions.
Go, Craig.
Pass?
Pass. Have a think about it. Maybe come back to it later. Mm. Maybe not. That's cool.
Craig, you're a little hot.
Goodbye, Dolly.
Take care.
Let's go to line the third.
Hello.
Hello, who's there?
Alison.
Hi, Alison. Who's your question for, Alison?
Kylie.
Go for it.
Far away.
What's your neighbours like, and do they give you any problems?
No, I have very nice, quiet neighbours.
Don't
know half of them, so...
They've become good friends.
have become good friends.
I think that's a good thing. I'm trying to learn the lyrics so I can make another poor gag.
They can come and get sugar from me anytime.
Aww. There you go, my love.
Thank you very much. We've got a question out from our
good
cake
evening.
Shop, and this is from our website. Thank you to everyone who's writing in. This is from Tracy Johns. Kylie, if you're being sent to a desert island and were allowed to take one person, one record, obviously with something to play it on, and one item, what would they be? So, one person.
I've just seen you.
I know.
Sorry.
One person, one record, really bad socks.
Now this is a question that I hate.
We're not having much luck today, are we?
No.
Don't hate.
One person.
Don't hate us.
Oh.
One record, maybe.
One record.
I guess I'd have to take a mating type of person so we could procreate.
Good call.
Yes.
Because I would have thought a family member, but that probably would be good.
What luxury would you say? I'm helping you, Kylie.
Luxury.
One thing, one item,
pants.
Any item.
Pants are going to be involved. Yes, sunblock.
Yeah, umbrella.
What about you, Selena? Any luxury you could take?
Tempany, not Selena, mate.
I have to end this show. I need to try and find my mind where have I lost it. I apologise, Tempany.
Well, that's where it all has to end. So from the upside down cake world of light lunch, we must wish you good day. Don't forget, Kylie's new single is out on Monday, and let's wait and see if Selena makes it to the church on time.
Have a fantastic evening. I hope to get my brain.